my channel. So today I'm here with 5 tips on Friday for you all. It's like OMG, cheers! I can't believe this is actually my 94th 5 tips on Friday. So I hope you guys enjoyed this helpful video, and let's just jump right into it. Okay, so the first tip is, since Valentine's Day is in like a week, and that's why I'm all festive in my pink, purple, in my red sweater with the little heart and my key, because you need to take the key to unlock that heart. And if you don't have a Valentine, you can still do something special on Valentine's Day. Relax with a Valentine's Day bath with your own homemade bath salts. All you do is need some Epsom salt and dried out rose petals to make this awesome bath salt. You can either use Epsom salt or sea salt, your choice. So the first thing you want to do is you just want to go right ahead and grab your Epsom salt and your dried up rose petals, and you just want to put a little bit of the Epsom salt into a jar like this, and then you just want to pour up your crumbled dried up roses into the Epsom salt. Mix that all together, and there you have your own homemade DIY bath salt. See how easy that was? Baths are so relaxing, and they have so many benefits to them. If you're either doing this bath for Valentine's Day or just a regular day, it has a lot of benefits. Soaking in rose water helps rejuvenate the skin and helps tone it. While the rich minerals in bath salts helps relieve achy muscles and stress. So if you were stressed out on that test, this bath will help you be stress-free. There you go, you have your own rose bath salt. You can also give this awesome bath salt as a gift to one of your friends if you wanted to. You could put it in a cute little jar and tie a bow around it and put like a little tag on it if you wanted to give it for a gift, which is also a super cute Valentine's Day gift. Or, you know, that's someone special.
Picture a guy making this for like his girlfriend. That'd be so adorable. Like if my guy came to me and was like, Allie, I made you a homemade bath salt. That'd be so adorable. I'd be like, oh, babe. And he'd be like, yeah. Too bad I don't have a boyfriend to make that for me. Just kidding. No, not just kidding about the non-boyfriend part, but just kidding about the crying part, because, you know, the single life. Anyways, I'm getting weird.
Okay, so the next tip is, did you know rose lip colors brighten your complexion instantly? But what is the perfect rose lipstick for you? There's so many different shades. If you have fair skin like me, your best choice for rose lipstick is a pinky rose that's brighter. So this one is the one that I wear all the time. It really brightens up my complexion. Every single time that I feel like whenever I wear it, it brightens up my complexion instantly. And this is a lipstick from MAC, which is Lady Gaga Viva Glam Gaga. Our pasty skin needs a vibrant rose to give our fair complexion a nice glow. So that's why this rose lipstick is perfect for people who have fair skin. If you have medium skin, use a rose lipstick with a bit of cocoa in it, like a tint of cocoa. It would be more like a mauve rose. So my favorite is out of this Lorac Indulge in Berry Kisses Cheek and Lip Stain. And what I do is I normally mix this one and this one together to get that perfect rose mauve. That warmth of the brown makes it blend in perfectly with your medium skin tone. So you don't have that bright rose lipstick and it just doesn't go with your face. So it's just blend beautifully in with your skin tone. If you have darker skin, the best rose lipstick is one with a little bit more fuchsia in it. This one has a little bit more red in it. This really dramatic rose shade gives your darker skin color a beautiful hint of color. If you're fair like I am, the best choice is a brighter, pinkier rose lipstick like this. If you are medium shade, choose a rose with a little bit more of a cocoa color in it, like a mauve, like these two mixed together. And if you have darker skin, grab a fuchsia color like this. I want to see a picture of you wearing your nice rose lipstick on Valentine's Day. Be sure to post pictures to me on Instagram and on Twitter. Links will be in the down bar. Okay, so last last few tips are kind of more gifty for Valentine's Day. And since Valentine's Day is going to be on Friday of next week, I thought it would only be appropriate to show you guys some tips on this Friday instead of next Friday, to give you guys a few tips on what you can give your friends or your Valentine for Valentine's Day. Next tip is for a Valentine gift for your friend, or if you want to give your Valentine, you can go out to the store and buy a lip balm, and then you can go ahead and take off the wrapper of the lip balm so that it doesn't have a wrapper on anymore. And then you can go out to the store and get all-purpose labels like these. These are just white all-purpose labels, and you can go ahead and write on the label, "Kiss me." I thought this was the cutest thing ever, just to give your Valentine a cute extra little gift, and it's just really cute and I really like it. You can put a bunch of different things on. Also print on these like little labels, so you could get like a little print like with like hearts on it if you wanted to. You could put them in your printer if you wanted to go to that extent. And it's just a cute little gift, and you know how many things you can use lip balm for. Just look at all my old fan tips on Fridays. You can use lip balm for everything. So the next gift tip I love, and this one is just another cute gift that you could leave on your Valentine's desk in school, or you could slip it into their locker if you wanted to, or it's just something cute and fun that you could give to your friends also. And what you want to do is you just want to go right ahead and get some Hershey Kisses! And you'll be needing the all-purpose Avery labels again. Also be needing a hole puncher like this that punches out hearts. This one's by Martha Stewart, and it punches out hearts. It's the cutest thing ever. So I'm just gonna take my heart hole puncher and punch a hole into the Avery stickers. And then what I wanna do is I'm just gonna take that off and put it on the Hershey Kiss. And I'm gonna write something cute on it, like "you're hot," something that you'll see on a sweet tart, kind of. And there you go, you have a really unexpected cute little gift on the bottom of the Hershey Kiss. I absolutely love this. And then you can also make a few of these up and put them into a little gift bag tied with a bow and put a lot of them, and then they're like little cute surprises at the bottom of each Hershey Kiss. Last Valentine gift tip I absolutely love! You'll be needing for this gift tip is just a few simple things. You'll be needing some plastic gift wrap like this, some tissue paper, a straw, some Hershey Kisses, and some green floral wrap tape like this. Oh, and you'll also be needing a dot glue runner. So what you want to do is you just want to take your glue dot and put it on the bottom of one of the Hershey Kisses like this. Then you want to stick another Hershey Kiss to the bottom of that one, flat sides together. Then taking your little plastic Saran gift wrap, you want to wrap it around both of the Hershey Kisses tight, creating like a little bit like together so you can twist it at the bottom. Now with the extra gift wrap plastic, you want to take it to the straw with your florist wrap and wrap it around the entire Hershey Kiss extra gift wrap and wrap it around the straw so then they're together. This is going to create your stem to your rose Hershey Kiss. And there you have it! Roses made out of Hershey Kisses! I took a piece of tissue paper and put it underneath the roses to make it look a little bit more realistic. This is what the final gift looks like. Look at how cute this is. This is actually Hershey Kisses turned into roses. How cute. I absolutely love this gift tip so much. It is so adorable, and I'm sure your Valentine will absolutely love it. This is also another great gift to give to your friends, just because it's not like lovey-dovey, but it's something cute. And it's Hershey Kiss. You can also add a little tag to it like this one. It's super cute. You can go ahead and add it on there and be like, "Will you be mine, Valentine," or something. And then I just punched a hole out of it with my little heart hole puncher. Super easy, super cute, and it's that perfect gift to give your Valentine or just your friend for Valentine's Day. So yeah, that is it, Dazzle. That concludes my 94th 5 Tips on Friday. I hope that you guys enjoyed this helpful video, and if you did, definitely go ahead and give it a thumbs up, and be sure to subscribe because a new video will be up every single day in February. If you guys are not familiar with it, I'm doing 28 days, 28 outfits, and I'm uploading an outfit of the day every single day in February, so you guys don't want to miss one of those. Also, be sure to come back next week because more great tips are coming your way. Talk to you later. I love you guys so very much. Hope that everyone's a wonderful, great night, evening, wherever you are, and I love you guys. Mwah! Happy Friday, everyone! So today I am here with my 7th outfit in my segment, 28 Days, 28 Outfits. So I really hope you guys enjoy.